At present, the rate of use of aluminum foil is increasing day by day in various important fields, including cooking, electronic devices, packaging of various food products or other products, art and decoration, laboratories. It is estimated that 75% of aluminum foil is used for packaging of foods, cosmetics, and chemical products, and 25% is used for industrial applications like thermal insulation, electrical cables, and electronics. The use of aluminum foil by people around the world has increased so much that approximately 7 billion aluminum foil containers are produced annually. This production rate nets to 220 containers produced every second. According to 2023 data, about 320 million Americans use aluminum foil every year, which is 95.5% of the total population of the country. But many of us still don't know the production process of this aluminum foil. There are many aluminum foil users in our world who don't know what ingredients aluminum foil consists of. They don't know what parts are used in aluminum foil production. In today's video, I present to you all kinds of unknown topics, including aluminum foil material, manufacturing process, and unraveling all kinds of mysterious history about aluminum foil. This video is going to be very enjoyable and surprising for you. So stay with us throughout the entire video to know more about aluminum foil. Aluminum has been used commercially for over 100 years. But at one time, foil was made from a thin leaf of tin that was commercially available before its aluminum counterpart. Conceived as a replacement for tin foil, Robert Victor Neyer took out a patent in 1910 for the continuous rolling process and opened the first aluminum rolling plant in Kreuzlingen, Switzerland. And by 1911, Bern-based Tobler began wrapping its chocolate bars in alufoil, including the unique triangular chocolate bar, Toblerone. And by 1912, alufoil was being used by Maggi to pack soups and stock cubes. Aluminum foil was first produced commercially in the U.S. in 1913, where it was used for wrapping lifesavers, candy bars, and chewing gum. In 1921, it was laminated on paperboard to produce coated folding cartons. Household foil was marketed in the late 1920s, and the first heat-sealable foil was developed in 1938. Aluminum foil is 98.5% aluminum, with the balance primarily from iron and silicone. So at first, it is very important to collect aluminum to make aluminum foil. Aluminum, the third most abundant element on the Earth's crust after oxygen and silicone, is extracted from an ore called bauxite. The first step of aluminum foil manufacturing is, number one, bauxite mining and refining. Our current world produced about 380 million metric tons of bauxite in each year. Bauxite, rock largely composed of a mixture of hydrous aluminum oxides. Bauxite is found in most countries, but the larger deposits occur in the tropics. Major deposits of gravels mixed with sand were discovered in Australia in the 1950s. And it became the world's top producer of bauxite by the early 21st century. Other top producers include China, Indonesia, Brazil, and India. Bayer's process is commonly used to produce alumina by refining bauxite, and researchers believe that this process is the most efficient and cost-effective. Aluminum compounds in the bauxite may be present as gibbsite, bomite, or diaspor, and other aluminum compounds. In the Bayer process, bauxite ore is heated in a pressure vessel along with a caustic soda at a temperature of 150 to 200 degrees Celsius. At these temperatures, the aluminum is dissolved as sodium aluminate in an extraction process. After separation of the residue by filtering, gibbsite is precipitated when the liquid is cooled and then seeded with fine-grained aluminum hydroxide crystals from previous extractions. Number 2, casting. The production castings, fine aluminum ingots suitable for rolling, heated to melt into molten metal. Some manufacturers will add the rolling debris to formulate different purity aluminum ingots, but the total purity is guaranteed. Molten metal generally use rolling to become billets by continuous casting. Number 3, uniform treatment. The cast billet is maintained at a high temperature close to the melting point for 20 to 30 hours and is homogenized. As a result of this treatment, the deformation in the casting can be well eliminated, and the impurities also dissolved in solid solution, and the impurity distribution becomes uniform. Number 4, surface cutting. Billet has irregular surface and the oxide layer, so it needs to be cut about 8 to 10 millimeters thick. Number 5. Hot rolled. After the billet is heated at about 5,000 degrees Celsius, the billet is put onto a rolling mill and hot rolled. Rolling about 10 times, pressure to about 3 to 5 millimeters thick, rolled into coils. During rolling, and recrystallization occur at the same time. The foundry structure is destroyed, resulting in rolled structure. When hot rolled, the crystal grain size of the high purity aluminum is about 0.5 millimeters. Number 6. Cold rolled. The hot coil is cold rolled at about 800 degrees Celsius while cooling. After about 3 times, rolled to about 0.5 to 0.6 millimeters thick, rolled into coils. This is what we commonly call the original foil. Number 7. Foil rolling. The original foil is cold rolled into thin foil by a high precision rolling machine. Aluminum can be rolled to a minimum of 5 mu. When rolling about 10 mu or less, 2 overlapping rolling can be used. The original foil achieved the required thickness by rolling several times. Number 8. Wash winding. The rolling is finished, the rolled oil is washed away and then wound into rolls. Number 9. Annealing. Hard foil is generally through heat treated, annealed to semi-hard or to the end of recrystallization. Sometimes provide a very soft foil by high temperature annealing close to the melting point. Annealing is an important process that determines the nature of the foil. In addition, in order to impart special properties to the aluminum foil, annealing is also carried out during the rolling. Number 10. Cut the foil. Aluminum foil produced only by rolling has irregular edges. Moreover, most users require foil that is narrower than the maximum width of the rolling. Therefore, not only about the edge of the foil, but also the rolling direction should be cut. This process is called cutting the foil. It is sometimes also carried out before annealing. Number 11. Packaging. Once the aluminum foil has been produced and inspected, it is typically wound onto large spools or rolls. These rolls may then be packaged for shipping to customers or further processed into consumer packaging products. Each stage of the aluminum foil manufacturing has a specific step associated with it, which is quality control. A lot of emphasis is placed on quality control to make aluminum foil usable and most hygienic. There are several points to emphasize in commercially producing aluminum foil, such as: aluminum foil must be malleable, opaque, and shiny. Its density should be maintained at 2.7 grams per cubic centimeter. Melting point should be 660 degrees Celsius, and an electrical conductivity of 64.94% IACS. Aluminum foil must also be non-toxic, tasteless, and odorless. Aluminum foil must be resistant to water, water vapor, grease, gas, UV rays, must be fire-resistant, and can be recycled. If you like the video, please click on the like button and share your valuable comments about aluminum foil in the comments. Stay with us by subscribing to our channel to get more informative videos like this. Your support motivates us to make new informative videos. Thank you all for being with us.